Maxim might appear compassionate, but I can assure you, the Institute faces you.
Now that you've had a chance to roam the Pridwin, what do you think, Knight?
Where did the Pridwin get her name?
Elder Maxon said he took the name from a work of historical fiction. Something about a man who was destined to become a king, and his journey to liberate his people from tyranny and oppression. Seems fitting for such a remarkable ship, wouldn't you say?
She's very impressive.
Yes, quite a feat of engineering, isn't she? It took the Brotherhood's sharpest minds over 2 years to design, and more than twice that to build.
That's a long time.
Constructing the Pridwin required a vast amount of resources, far more than the Brotherhood possessed when we began. We spent the first 2 years alone gathering the parts. The rest was spent assembling. It was worth the effort.
With the Pridwin in our arsenal, we can mobilize our entire division, sending her anywhere that Elder Maxon wishes her to go.
Her presence in the Commonwealth ensures that our mission to defeat the Institute will end in victory.
Did the Brotherhood ever build other airships?
There were less advanced versions of the ship built on the West Coast a long time ago. Historical records about their current status are in dispute, but we're fairly certain that they were destroyed. In any event, I hope your tour of the Pridwin helped acclimate you to our way of life up here. I think you'll find that the more familiar you become with both her capabilities and her crew, the longer you'll survive as a member of the Brotherhood. You're dismissed, Knight.
Try and keep him in your sights. scared already? No more!
on.
I'm on it.
Dance.
If you have a moment, there's something I'd like to discuss with you.
Does it have anything to do with the Brotherhood?
I wouldn't necessarily say that.
This isn't a formal meeting. I simply want to clear the air. I think we may have gotten off on the wrong foot when we first met, and I feel like I owe you an apology. Expecting you to embrace the standards of the Brotherhood without having a history with us was unfair. And given that you've adjusted so well to our beliefs, I don't think I needed to push so hard.
That's very kind. Thank you.
Well, you deserve it. When I was an initiate, my sponsor was Paladin Krieg, toughest squad leader I ever served with.
He was a model soldier, embodying the values every trainee was striving to achieve. Fiercely loyal, secure in his beliefs, and brave to a fault. From the moment I was assigned to his squad, I was singled out. It felt like he was pushing me harder than the rest of the team. I fought by his side for years, and we had some seriously close calls. But he never explained to me why I was treated that way.
Did you ever ask him why?
I'd considered it, but unfortunately, I never had the chance. After I was promoted to Paladin, and I'd moved on to my own squad, I received word that Krieg was killed at Adams Air Force Base. The news was like being kicked in the stomach. I mean, I'd lost some of my brothers and sisters before, but his death, well, it really got to me. It's taken me a long time to realize it. But the reason Krieg was so tough on me is the same reason I'm so tough on you. It's because I believe in you. And I don't want to see any of your potential go to waste.
I'm flattered that you have so much faith in me.
You've earned that faith by your own hand. Well, I've said what I had to say, and I hope that it meant something to you. I trust you'll keep this in confidence, of course. Some of that information was of a personal nature, and, well, I'd like to keep it that way.
Hey.
Need something?
Excuse me, Paladin Dance.
What do you want?
Your thoughts?
The Brotherhood rose from the ashes of the U.S. military, you know.
Your thoughts?
We should take a moment to remember all the soldiers who died fighting for what they believed in.
Your thoughts?
You watch my back, I'll watch yours.
How do you feel about our relationship?
I don't see how this is a relevant question right now.
That was all.
Not a problem.
Head would show up, and we'd be so boring.
Wounded!
that? I can smell you out there, little sneak. What is it? Only one of us survives this, and it won't be you.
Thank you. Look at this place.
You must hate these mutants as much as I do.
I was just doing what Elder Maxon asked. No more, no less.
Well, it's good to see you dealt with them the Brotherhood way. These monstrosities are just another example of man blindly taking a step forward, only to wind up stumbling two steps back. I've been fighting for years, trying to put a stop to this madness. And just when I thought we were getting the upper hand, along come the synths. I've seen what these super mutants do to people. Can you imagine what the synths would do to us if they ever got the upper hand? It would be Armageddon repeated, and maybe the end of everything that we hold dear. Look, I don't mean to bore you with my rhetoric. I just want you to understand how important these missions are.
How could synths bring about our destruction?
If the synths reached the point where they outnumbered mankind, how long would it take for them to decide we were no longer necessary? They certainly possess the capability to make more of their own kind, so we'd become expendable. And with Institute technology on their side, nothing could stop them. Not even the Brotherhood. It's a nightmare scenario almost too terrible to contemplate. Anyway, that's enough of that. What's important here is that you got the job done and secured these warheads. You should head back up to the Pridwin and talk to Maxon. I'm sure he'll want to debrief you as soon as possible. Dismissed. There's Brotherhood, then there's everything...
It's up to me. I take every feral, beauty, and synth and shit.
Getting a bit of a twitch on Prop 3. Adjusting torque.
Stray radio signals keep pinging the array. We'll try to filter it out.
Outstanding work at Fort Strong, soldier.
So what happens at Fort Strong now?
Paladin Dance is supervising the transfer of the Fat Man warheads to the Pridwin. They'll provide quite an edge to our arsenal. I've also ordered a detachment to occupy the location and use it as a staging area to protect the eastern side of the airport. All in all, you handed us quite a valuable location.
It was an honor fighting for the Brotherhood.
I'm glad you feel that way, because our mission here has only just begun. In order to bring the Institute to its knees, we need to use every weapon at our disposal. I try to supply my soldiers with the best. That's why I'm giving you these. Signal grenades can call a vertibird to your location when you need aerial transport. Simply throw one to the ground, and the vertibird will hone in on the unique electromagnetic smoke it emits. Once you're aboard, use the map on your pit boy to interface with the pilot's navigation system, so he'll be able to take you wherever you need.
Where can I get more signal grenades?
I'd use the supply I gave you sparingly. These devices are far more complex than a standard smoke grenade. Should you need more, you should acquire them from Proctor Teagan.
Thank you, Elder. I'll make good use of them.
I expect that you will. Now, I'm sure you're aware that Fort Strong was simply the first step towards the liberation of the Commonwealth. An even greater task lies ahead. By now, I'm sure you've deduced that our arrival in the Commonwealth wasn't coincidental. We're here because of a unique energy reading recorded by Paladin Dance's recon team. According to our scribes, the reading indicated a level of technology that only the Institute could achieve. The moment this information came to light, our mission became clear. The Institute, and everyone responsible for the creation of the synths, must be eliminated at all costs. To accomplish this goal, we need to locate the Institute's headquarters. I've had our scribes meticulously searching the Commonwealth, but they've come up empty-handed.
Where do I start?
I want you to get out there and become our eyes and ears on the ground. You seem to have a vested interest in locating the Institute before we met, so I'm confident you'll travel in the right circles. If you discover a way in, I need you to report it to me immediately. Any questions, Knight?
Any suggestions on where I should look next?
I'd pursue your lead regarding Dr. Amari. I'm not certain if she's a crackpot or if she can genuinely assist your search. But our sources say she has some interesting technology at her disposal. Anything else, Knight?
What about those energy readings Paladin Dance's recon team detected?
Our scribes are confident that the energy readings are from Institute technology, due to the unusually high frequency. But the source is unknown. We're still detecting them on occasion. But by the time we send a team to investigate, they disappear. Just watch your step. I wouldn't be surprised if the energy reading were caused by some type of Institute weapon. Is there anything else?
Aren't there any pre-war records about the Institute that might help us?
Our records indicate that the Institute was born from the remnants of a pre-war educational facility, the Commonwealth Institute of Technology. The ruins of the facility are at the center of the city, but we've already searched them thoroughly. The location appears to have been abandoned long ago, so it appears that the trail ends there. Anything else, Knight?
Not right now, Elder.
Very well, then. Dismissed.
Pinging remote units at 30-second intervals as requested.
Control systems all reporting back nominal.
Superstructure integrity green. Hull plating.